As a young musician, what were your motivations to continue to study music?
You want an honest answer? I never thought about it. I just did it. I didn't need to have a motivation because my violin was with me and I was already married with that instrument when I was 7 years old, when I got it. And maybe this is an interesting story. My father was a piano teacher, and you know, in his free time he was playing with gypsies in restaurants. And when he rehearsed with gypsy violinists at our home, and I was then 6 years old, that was actually the inspiration for me to choose that instrument, because him playing with these violinists, I wanted to do that myself. So I got finally an instrument, and immediately I knew I'm going to stick with that instrument. So I never had a thought about going on or not going on or quitting. I never thought about it. Yes, go ahead.
Was it harder or easier for you to first understand the concepts of music theory?
Yes, it was a little hard because I was just interested in the melodies and in the notes, and the rest, you know, was just an obstacle, I thought. But finally, at the school where I went to, they made it interesting. They made it joyful to go to these classes, and that's a very important thing, because if you play an instrument well and you have to do your theory, you have to be very careful that you are not saying, look, the instrument is 99% and the theory is just 1%. You have to take that seriously. Otherwise, later in your career, you will face troubles. So it is very important that you do that.
Hi, what is the... What do you suggest someone does in order to become a professional orchestral conductor?
Well, first of all, you need to know how to conduct. And so there are classes for that. You can take classes. And then I would suggest, if you play an instrument, and I hope before you conduct that you can also play an instrument, I would suggest go into an orchestra and see how it is if you have somebody in front of you who is a conductor, and look at him or her, look at that person, how they are doing it, how they are doing that, and learn from that. Stay a few years in an orchestra, and then you can make the next step and conduct yourself, if you want to.
I think we have time for one more, Jamie.
Yes, we've got one question right here.
What single person has had the greatest influence on your musical career?
My father. The other person who really made me realize that I should change from violin playing to conducting was Lenny Bernstein. He was conducting the orchestra. I was the leader in Berlin, and we had a concert there. And he wanted to go into the hall, and he asked me, "Could you please conduct Mahler's First Symphony?" In the rehearsal. And I told him, well, I never did that. And he said, yes, okay, I understand that, but can you please do it? And I said, Lenny, no, please don't make me do that, because I will really be very bad in that. And he said, okay, still do it. I will go in the hall and you will do that symphony. Now, you could at that time you could not refuse Leonard Bernstein asking you to do things. So I did it. And afterwards he came to me and he said, "Well, that was pretty bad, but I saw something there. You should take lessons, take it seriously, and go on with that." So he was a very important person also in my conducting career. Yes. So he and my father.
Thank you, Jaap, and I hope you enjoy the rehearsal. Thanks for coming. Thank you.